Speaking of music stars, let's take a listen here.
To staying up and waking up with you.
All right, the season of American Idol kicked off last night with contestants singing, hoping to make it to the next round.
And we are excited to be joined here live in studio by season two American Idol finalist Kimberly Locke. With the whole recap on everything from American Idol last night. What's up?
It was really good.
Did it bring back memories?
So many memories. Right? I think I cried like 3 times.
Really?
Oh.
Well, I really did.
I'm so glad it's back.
Yes.
I'm even more excited that it's on ABC. Big Disney fan.
Right.
And last night, the storytelling was so great. The singing was great. This panel of judges...
You like it? Really, really good.
You know what? They were honest.
Mm-hmm.
They were sincere. And I think they were judging based upon talent. You know, mm-hmm. Lionel Richie, you know, said something to one of the contestants. He said, if we put you through, mm-hmm. you're going to die 1,000 deaths.
Mm.
And I was like, ouch.
Yeah.
Okay.
But true.
The burn.
And I thought it was great. I mean, you don't get, that panel is pretty awesome.
And you mentioned Lionel Richie. We actually have a quick soundbite from him. Let's take a listen and kind of get your reaction on this.
I always say it goes back to the old school. What's your style? You've got a style, that means you'll be around for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? If you're a singer, maybe, maybe not. But stylists are the people who last forever.
So he's talking all about style, how you can't just be a singer. You have to be the best singer.
You have to have a little personality to go along with it.
I think that is absolutely true.
Yeah.
And I think in the past, you know, maybe some of the contestants got in because mm-hmm. they have a style.
Mm-hmm.
They're not necessarily the best singers, but they had some type of style about them that's going to evolve throughout the course of the show. And that's what people love about the show, the evolution of it all, right?
That's true.
Watching us turn into, you know, superstars, change our clothes, change our hair, you know, our sound. So it's true. And I mean, listen, if Lionel Richie says it, I believe it.
That's true. So let's talk about your experience just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
What we're watching on TV, is there a lot of editing going on? Is there a long process to get in front of the judges?
So what the part that we're watching right now, this preliminary judging round, there's a lot of editing going on, okay? But what you don't see, so from my experience, this part with the judges, mm-hmm. you had like 4 or 5 auditions before you got there to the judges.
Wow. Okay.
So they're really weeding people out. So when you get to the judges, when I actually stood in front of the judges, there were only 63 people left.
No kidding.
From thousands. So you understand, you know, how big it really is. You're like, oh my gosh, where did all these people go? They went home.
Yeah.
So
you heard it down.
The process is pretty intense. This is where you go home and you're like, oh my gosh, I have this golden ticket. What does it mean?
Yeah.
Or at least that's what I do.
What do I do from here? Would you have a different approach with these judges versus the Simon and
you
Paula?
You went with the originals, right?
I don't think I would. I don't think I would. I'd probably be a little more nervous because I was a huge Lionel Richie fan growing up. You know, that Penny Lover video. If you've never seen it, you gotta go watch it.
Now, would you ever take the risk of singing a Lionel Richie song during an audition?
That's a little too bold for anyone.
Okay. All right.
I think that,
nobody should ever do that.
I don't think you should do that. Yeah. That's a bad idea. And that's a great point because song selection is very important. And I was surprised not to hear more people trying to do Katy Perry songs. That's the stuff that may have gotten edited out. Okay? Because you have 3 judges with wonderful careers who have a huge hit list.
Right.
So people are coming in and they're like, well, if I sing one of, and I'm going to advise against that. Don't do that.
Right.
Some people are actually singing their own original songs, which also maybe not such a great idea.
So I noticed that last night, and we couldn't do that my season.
Oh, okay.
So we had to do covers, and if somebody did a cover, they would actually ask you to sing something that they know, because think about when you go out and listen to music, you love to hear songs that you know.
No, right.
And I think that there's a level of comfortability with the listener and the performer when you're singing a song that everybody knows. And, you know, I actually, there was a couple of people who started singing their original songs last night, and I was like, it sounds off to me because I don't know the song.
Yeah, right.
So I don't think that's a safe bet either.
So, got to go with a cover. Don't sing Katy Perry, Luke Bryan.
Something popular.
But I will say this, there were some great originals last night. Okay, so you need to go back
and watch the show. Back, right?
That's what I'm doing right here after CT Style. I'm sitting down watching the entire thing. What do you think we can expect this season? What do you think is going to be different, exciting? What are you most looking forward to?
So I thought they were going to come out of the gate with something different, and they didn't. They kept the original format.
Old school, right?
It's old school.
Which seems to work, though, right?
It seems to work. If it's not broke, you know,
don't fix it.
Yeah. So I look forward to that Disney pixie dust being sprinkled all over this, especially when they hit the big stage. Right. Because, you know, the Disney magic is pretty real. You know, they ended last night in Orlando, which Disney's magical anyway. So I think that American Idol is magical in a different way, but they're going to put some extra stuff. I don't know.
I want to
know. Which is why I'm actually watching, because I want to see what they do.
Sounds great.
I want to see it.
Stuff. Kimberly, thank you so much. We'll have you back on. Because you're a talented chef, so we got to get her back in the kitchen.
Oh, kitchen.
Cooking with Kimberly.
That's right.
Well, and American Idol talk.
Yeah, more
more
food. Maybe we can do like pre-game American Idol
munchies. There you go. Idol parties. We love it. Kimberly, thanks for being here.
Thank you.